In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to unlock the ability to create 3D text. By simply changing the 3D renderer in your comp settings, you can unleash the 3D monster inside. There are some limitations that you need to be aware of, but don't worry, we'll cover all that in good time. We'll also have a little crash course in text animators, along with our usual tips, tricks, and shortcuts sprinkled throughout this tutorial. You definitely don't want to miss all the good stuff I have in store for you. Please comment, like, share, subscribe, click the bell, support us if you're so moved, and check out our affiliates. Links and project files are down below in the description. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so let's go ahead and create a new composition. And I wanted to do that specifically for this tutorial because this is where we make the first changes. Go to your 3D renderer. All projects default to this classic 3D renderer. So to get the effect we want, we need to change this. And now I'm in 2023. So the other option you have is Cinema 4D. So that's the setting we're going to need. So if you click that, some things to take note of. The things that are enabled, you can extrude shapes and text. You get reflections. The things that you don't have, you cannot use blend modes. Like you can't change normal to multiply or overlay, things like that. No alpha matting, luma matting. You cannot use layer styles, which is kind of a big deal. And also masks and effects on rasterized layers, which means shape layers and text in particular. So there are some limitations. So we're going to go ahead and click OK. Control or Command T to bring up your text tool. I'm just going to type 3D text, no plugins. Let's go ahead and turn off our transparency so you can see this text a little bit better. So if you hold down Command or Control and double click the pan around tool, it will center your anchor point. Let's just go to our alignment and we're going to line that right up. I'm using Gilroy Heavy. I can include this in the project file, but let's kind of tweak with some of these settings here. Pull this together a little bit tighter. Okay, and I want our text to stay in the same place, always centered. So a good way to do that, if you press P for your position, Option Alt click onto position and type value, comma, open bracket, and then you want the value of the position where you want this to be. Before we do that, let's go ahead and make this 3D because we're going to need to put in all three values. So value, comma, open bracket, 960, comma, 540, comma, 0. That puts it dead center in our comp, and it puts it at 0 on the Z-axis. If you just press P, you can't do anything to this. It's stuck there in the middle. So the good thing about this is that whenever our anchor point moves, all you have to do is Command, Control, and double-click on the pan around tool, and it will snap right back to the center of your composition. Now, I'm going to go over here to where it says Active Camera, and I'm just going to change this to Custom View 1. Fit this to our composition so it's full screen. So let's open up our text layer here, and we want to go down to geometry options. So first, I'm going to extrude our depth to 200, so that way it's pretty deep. Let's go to animate, and we want to add in a text animator for the color. So now you can see you have this front, bevel, side, and back. So I'm going to go to side color, RGB, and it defaults to red, but I want to change that. Now I've got my libraries open. These are a lot of the colors I tend to use for my tutorials. Take this eyedropper and I'm going to pick this red right here. Now let's go back to custom view one, change it back to active camera. Now I also want to do some beveling. So you have these options for bevel style. I like concave. I'll do the bevel depth up to 5 pixels. You can't really see what it's doing, but now watch this. If we go in here and go layer, new light, we just want to do a point light, intensity 100%, and click OK. Now we can see our bevel. So I'm just going to bring this light back a little bit. And let's increase our bevel depth maybe to 10. Now you can see the bevel on this text. However, we can't really see the sides of our text. So I'm going to duplicate that point light and then I'm going to move it. So let's go back to active camera, change it to custom view. Take this second light here and on the Z-axis, let's just push it until we can start to see the sides of our text. So that way that color pops a little bit. We can go up on the Y-axis to kind of get the top of our text. Go back to custom view one, change that back to active camera. Go ahead and turn on my transparency so it pops a little bit better. Now let's add in some text animators. Text layer selected, go to animate, and first let's enable per character 3D because we will be rotating each character. Now we're going to add in quite a few text animators, so just follow along, include the settings I'm doing, and you'll be good to go. So animate, first we'll do position. So let's go ahead and change these text animators. Animator 2 is our position text animator. Animator 1 is actually our side color. I always like to name all of these so that way I know exactly what these are doing. Start our position. We want it to come from off screen. So let's just say negative 3500. And I'm going to go ahead and change my resolution to quarter. So now let's just kind of tweak this Z position until we start to see our text. We want it to be somewhere just right off screen. So something like that. Go ahead and fit this back. And now let's open up our range selector and make some changes here. Ease low, so that's 100%. We want to change our shape from square to ramp up. Now, whenever you use ramp up or ramp down, your offset, this is going to be what we'll be using to animate. The range is from negative 100 to 100%. Negative 100, we'll put a keyframe there, go about a second, and make this offset 100. So I'm just going to loop that by pressing N, and if we watch it come on. Now, I don't like that left to right, so change your randomize order from off to on. So now if we watch that come on, it just randomizes which character comes in which order. Okay, so let's go to the 1 second mark. I'm going to close this up, and now let's add in another text animator. So animate, and we're going to add in rotation. Okay, so let's just rename this to rotation. We want our beginning X rotation to be -1. Changes to ramp up and offset, we want to go -100 up to 100. We can see how it's going to start animating. Now notice the anchor point is really, really weird on this. So there's a trick that we can do. We needed to add in an anchor point text animator that's going to recenter our text so it animates from the dead center of our text layer. So let's go up to text, animate, and add in an anchor point, and we're going to rename this animator anchor point. Since we have our extrusion depth at 200, we want to move our anchor point on the Z axis to 100. And then your anchor point is these little X's. Let me see if I can show you real quick. Turn off our transparency. It makes them a little bit better. It's these little X's right here. So we actually want that to be up further. So let's make our Y value, we'll say -110, and see if that puts this right where it needs to be. It's about in the middle, which is exactly what we're looking for. Let's go back to fit composition, and now we need our text to be centered again. So if we select that layer, Command or Control, double click the pan around tool, it'll pop it right back up for us in the middle. Okay, if we watch it play back, we can see that it animates in first our position from off screen, and then it does this little rotation per character. I'm just going to select those and F9 to make those Bezier, and maybe pull these in a little bit tighter. Okay, so now I do want to add some effects, but remember, if we go back up to our comp settings, and we look at our 3D renderer, masks and effects are not recognized. So we need to pre-comp this in order to add some effects in. So let's just select these three layers. Let's go to layer, pre-compose, and we'll call this 3D text. Drag this 3D text into a new composition. Now we need to make sure that this composition has the right settings. So Command or Control K to bring up our settings and our 3D renderer. We need to change this back to classic 3D so that way we can start adding in effects. So just click OK. I want to add in a background first. So Command or Control Y. And I'm going to be using a gradient ramp so the color doesn't matter. Let's go to our effects and presets and just type in gradient ramp. And with that layer selected, double click our generate gradient ramp. I'm going to pull this underneath our text. I'm going to make some changes to our gradient ramp. First, I want to make our ramp radial, and then I'm going to use some colors from my libraries again. Now, for this dark color, let's go ahead and color pick this red color that I have as part of my libraries. We can also color pick the start color to the end color, so that way they're the same color. Then all I have to do is grab the end color and just darken it. Okay, and I'm just going to grab this start of ramp circle right here and move this over to the corner. Okay, so I'm going to go to where our text is already animated in. And I don't want this quite so full screen. So let's go back into this pre-comp. And we're going to select our layer and hit S for scale. Maybe bring us down about 85. So that way it's a little bit smaller. We'll maybe say even 75. And we need to make sure that our animation from our position is still going off screen. Because as you get smaller, it kind of pulls it in. And as we can see, it is not off screen at the beginning. And also, our light, we need to pull that light back a little bit. So this is our front light here. And I'm just going to pull this back on the Z axis until we can see all of our text. Now, with our text layer selected, go to your Finder bar and type POS for position. It's the quickest way to find your text animator. So now we just need to come back a little bit further. So we'll say maybe 3,000, negative 3,500. Pull back, we can see we're right there at the edge, so maybe a little bit further. This is where we need to be. Okay, so let's go back out to our main comp here. Command or Control K. I'm just going to rename this Final Animation. Okay, so now I want to add in some effects to give this a little bit of a different look, something that looks a little bit more unique and a little bit better. So let's go over to our effects and presets, and let's look for CC glass. And we want to select that layer and just double click CC glass. We have some changes. It kind of gives us a different look, but not quite exactly what we need. So let's open this up. Just need to make two changes on our surface settings here. Softness, let's make that 15, and height, we'll make that 10. And then I want to add in another effect, CC plastic. So double click that. And then let's open up our surface bump, and we want to change our softness. We'll do the opposite. We'll make that 10, and we'll make our height 15. I need to adjust my tracking on this text. So let's select that layer, go to your character panel, and let's set our tracking here to 0 to kind of spread out those characters a little bit more. And maybe we'll go even a little bit further. We'll say maybe 20. Let's go back to our final animation. And the other thing I want to add in is a drop shadow. So we'll just look for drop shadow. And then let's change some of these settings. We'll make our distance maybe 15. And then our softness will go up to 50. So that way we just kind of have some depth here. Maybe even kind of offset it more like that. Okay, so let's loop this area by pressing N. And I'm going to change this back to quarter quality so it doesn't take forever to pre-render. Hit 0 and let's watch it play back. I'm going to change this back to full quality. Get to a point in here where the text is rotating. You get some really cool little light elements like here, like around the edges, and just the way that some of it has like that glassy, plasticky kind of look. So you kind of get this shine on this. If you take off CC glass and CC plastic, you can really see the difference that that makes. So now you may want to tweak this a little bit differently. You can adjust your beveling, whatever you want to do to kind of get the right look that you want. And since this is pre-composed, you can change your text and it updates automatically. So I'm going to select that. I'm going to type in 7-minute AE tutorials. And to ensure that our text is in the middle of our comp, command or control, select the layer and double click on the pan around tool, and it will snap right to the middle. One other thing that's kind of cool, if I want my text to change color before and after the rotation, watch this. So we can go to our rotation folder here, and we want to add in a color. So we want our front color, we'll go RGB, to be different. So this is our start color, right? So let's open up our library, and maybe we'll make this start color like this soft yellow here. And we also need to add in one for our bevel, because those need to be the same exact color. So see, whenever I put in bevel color RGB, you can see that the bevel is going to initially turn red. So I want to make this the same color as my front. Go past that second keyframe. Let's change our text color. We'll make it this blue. So what we're basically doing is we added in a text animator and set the color for our text to begin at. But the final result is going to be whatever we have our text actually set to from the character panel. And since we put it inside of this folder with the rotation, it's going to be using all the values that we use to animate the rotation to animate the color. So it starts off with this lighter color, and I'm just going to quarter quality this. Actually, let's go ahead and loop this area real quick. So just this area, so that way it goes quicker. So as the letters flip over, they actually are going to change color because our text color is animating using the same properties as our rotation. And so that's the result that you get. So just kind of another cool little trick if you want to throw in a color that changes with your rotation. The key is make sure you put it in your rotation folder. And so that's how you can get some 3D text by just changing your comp setting. And we'll open that back up. So if we go to comp settings, if you change this to Cinema 4D, these are the limitations that you have. Look under the disabled list, blending modes, track mats, layer styles, effects, masks, all of that stuff you cannot use in a Cinema 4D composition. However, you can get some really cool effects on your text. Give it a shot. Check out my text animator tutorials if you want to go more in depth on how to use text animators. And thanks for watching. I'd like to thank the good folks over at AE Juice for sponsoring this video. If you haven't checked them out at aejuice.com, I highly recommend you do just that right now. Get tons of free plugins from AE Juice that will save time while adding polish and professionalism to your projects. Get the AE Juice Starter Pack, which contains over 100 assets for your projects, including liquid and shape elements, liquid transitions, slides for your slideshows, text presets,
flat icons, 2D and 3D assets, and so much more. AE Juice also offers professionally produced sound effects absolutely free. Other free plugins include a HUD package that is super cool. These elements would literally take hours to create, but with AE Juice, you get them absolutely free and they can be dropped into your project with the click of a button. Some of my personal favorite free plugins include Copy Ease, which allows you to copy the speed graph of your keyframes and paste them so you get identical keyframe speeds. I also use Shifter on a regular basis. Instead of going through the multiple steps of offsetting layers, this plugin allows you to do it with the click of a button, which saves a tremendous amount of time. In addition to these impressive free plugins, you can also purchase advanced products at more than reasonable prices. Take advantage of AE Juice's bundles. My personal recommendation is that you get the I Want It All bundle, which includes everything I just showed you. I've been approached by several sponsors and I will not promote their products unless I support them, use them, and highly recommend them. AE Juice is an amazing product and company, and in my opinion, it's a necessity for any serious motion graphic designer. AEJuice.com.
I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.